call meeting to order. It is 7:01, March 9th, 2023. We're gonna skip that and we just go back here. Roll call.
Flores.
Here.
Gonzalez.
Here.
Hussein. Jost.
Here.
Lisa Jack.
Here.
Pelletier, here. Huzo.
Here.
Call comments, agenda items only. It's just here, just us tonight. So, moving on, I'll make a motion to approve the items on the consent agenda.
Awesome.
Do I open it up to questions or answers? Questions, comments on the, these are the items.
There should be, we're.
Right, that's what we just moved on.
Yeah, sorry. So, prior to the consent agenda, we should ask if anyone wants to pull anything off.
Okay, thank you. See, this is, we have some, you know.
Yeah, no, no, that's okay.
Practice. Yes. Yeah, okay, so, any, what, you know, questions or comments, anything you wanna address on the consent agenda? And then I would make a motion. And then we would second.
And then we would vote.
Yes, okay. I'll be ready.
Doing amazing.
What's up?
You're doing amazing.
Can we approve by voice vote or do we need roll call for that?
We can approve by voice. No, I would say, I would recommend that you do it by roll call.
Oh, correct, yes. Okay. Gonzalez.
Here.
Yes. Jost.
Yes.
Lisa Jack.
Yes.
Pelletier, yes. Huzo.
Yes.
Flores.
Yes.
Thank you. Okay. So we'll move on. President's report, I do have a little bit.
Wait a minute, hold on. This is a consent agenda. There's approval, you have these two items here. We have, nobody approved the financial.
That's in the consent agenda.
That's why she asked if we wanted to pull anything up, right?
Okay, so I have something on the financial before we move along. If anybody have any questions on any of these. I really do. On any of the financial statements. Like the general ledger. You'll note that Wintrust, not Wintrust, Fifth Third Bank has $121,000 still in that account, which I believe that you need to pay down the.
That account.
Go on.
Okay, the public, the loan.
Right, because Fifth Third holds that loan. So this will not pay off the loan, but it'll, it's used to pay the loan. Now, my question is, when this money's gone, then it's coming out of Wintrust, correct?
You have to close that account, you have to make that switch over. So we haven't done that with Fifth Third yet. They've been a little bit of a check to work with me to do that. So I don't know if we can work with that, yeah. So if, so bottom line, you know, if we don't get a transfer, we would just make sure that we transfer enough money in there to continue to allow them.
To pay it from Wintrust.
We would pull the money out of Wintrust and transfer it into Fifth Third.
If they're reluctant, I need us closing that account?
Right. They have indicated that they thought it was easier for us to leave it open for their time. They've been reluctant to close it, but I will work with them on getting that done.
I don't understand how they can be reluctant.
Well, they are reluctant. So we wanted to get all the other accounts transferred, so we went ahead and did that. And we left that one open just for now so that I could work with our rep there to get that finished, because there was other paperwork that needed to be involved. And so I wanted to get the other accounts closed first. They will transfer it. I mean, they will have to.
They have to.
Yeah, they will. But for expediency sake, to get the rest of the accounts closed, we need to open this one to leave that in there.
Right.
Just to get through the year, or get through the first part of the year, and then I'll work with them to get closed and get that.
And then the money will be, the loan will be paid out of Wintrust account. Are we paying that by check or is it?
I don't know yet.
You don't know yet?
Yeah, it would just depend. Right now, it's being debited out of their account for Fifth Third. I assume that they can also do that with Wind Trust, but like I said, there's other people that's involved with that, so I didn't really want to do that. So how would they want to handle that? Either way, it would be different.
And that's what we would honor, that we would control it.
Okay.
Okay, so President's report, yeah, I do have something to report regarding the decennial committee, but that is on the agenda for a little bit later, so I'll kind of combine that with that. So staff reports, anything that you'd like to highlight or add?
I don't think so, unless anyone has any specific questions. I did address the ethics policy, which I actually was going to review and prove later on in the item as well. So unless anyone has any questions, I can answer them.
Oh, I just have a question. How was your first meeting with the fire? I have been thinking about that, but it's always on that evening.
It was pretty interesting. So they spent some time kind of, you know, Chief of Police himself, they was the deputy chief there, one of the deputy chiefs, and then the fire department, or one of the district chiefs for the fire department. So they talked kind of over, you know, the general structure of the police department right now, and then talked about what the next classes will be. We have a tour of the police department, and so it was pretty interesting. I think it should be fun.
Yeah.
So next week we go to, so Morton Road, all the emergency calls are just kept through Glenview. Mm-hmm. So next week we go to the Glenview Police Department to see that, and then the following week we'll be in the fire department. So we'll get to play with the hoses. We'll get to do some stuff as a fire department, and then also with the police department throughout the course of everything. So it should be pretty interesting, like I said, I think it'll be a good way to kind of, you know, foster better relations.
And it's awesome.
I think it's great.
Mm-hmm. There should be. I wasn't quite sure what to expect, but I think it should be.
We look forward to welcoming Wynn.
Yes, we do. He was very, super excited to accept him.
That's great.
And I think it'll be a great position, really personable. You know, I think it'll be just a super good fit. I mean, coming from that, I'll be familiar with so many of the, you know, the kind of the population and demographics of the area already. We share some of the weaknesses as well. So, and then it just brings us down to the department. So, yeah.
Any other questions for him?
Looking at Ed Tamos's report, he's saying that he's getting calls for evening cleaning crews.
We're looking at that again as a possibility, not 7 days a week, but fewer days during the week. We haven't made any firm decisions yet, so we're just exploring our options. What we found is it can be difficult if there's absences, like photo wind or not there out for any length of time. It's difficult for one person or even two people to kind of manage everything that has to happen on the campus. So, like I said, we're just exploring all of our options right now to see if that's viable for us to do, if that makes sense to start doing that again. And some of that. So, like I said, no point. Obviously, if that's a route we go, the board would have to approve that again. But right now, we're just exploring options.
Okay.
Yeah,
Always
think
of
them.
I'll be in
your
swimming. I'm pretty sure they don't be mad at the Philippines.
Any other questions for him or any other staff reports? So Pam and I chatted about that with February being a shorter month. Pam is also out of town. Unfortunately, Pam was not feeling well, and her husband came back from the trip with COVID. So there was just some extra stuff. So, you know, it was on Pam's radar, and we did chat about it. And rather than, you know, scurry to put something together for tonight, I said, let's just, you know, leave it to April. And we kind of reviewed the rest of the progress reports for the rest of the year. So, you know, that was not a conscious, you know, error. It is something that PAM's aware of. So we'll circle back on in April. So, and I'm glad that you're feeling better.
Yeah.
Your husband's feeling better.
Yeah, you have relatively mild case.
Good.
So that's good. And I was out, but I think there's only ever an action that I'm not as
Those are no fun. So we move on to unfinished business. So my part of this report is I did officially ask Suzanne to join us on the committee. It makes a lot of sense. Not only is she more of a resident, she fulfills that requirement. She's familiar with board functions. She will help the administrative part of that. So thank you for agreeing to be a part of that. I did also reach out, and I tried to get an email. Not look like Frank has responded, but I did think that was a good next ask. That again, he fulfills the more resident part of that, but he both his legal expertise and his familiarity with the board functions, I think, would also be a good addition. It is volunteer. I hope I outlined all that clear as possible. And I really tried to be like, I don't really understand, or, you know, like everything that we're supposed to be. But here's what we have, and please review and ask if any questions. He has yet to respond, so you know, hopefully, we'll move on to the next step if needed. So, and there is. You know, in conjunction with that, there was a little extra little, I don't know.
I included this because it gave a little bit more, information on things that we might want to cover in the report and stuff. So that was really good. Again, very little guidance, very little, there's been a lot of discussion on the record email list about which types of libraries have to comply with this, and a differing attorneys to different viewpoints about, you know, since we don't directly levy our own tax, there's some villages that their attorneys have said, no, you don't have to do it, and there's others that say you do. So it's kind of, I mean, it's, again, unfortunate that there was a little bit more clear guidance given with this, but
I feel
like that. I would recommend to err on the side of caution, and given that while we don't actually levy the tax, the village doesn't have any control over what this board decides to ask the people to want to go over. So, because by law, they have to, you know, if you guys decided to next year raise our levy request by 10%, the village could not do that with the complaint, but they could not do that. So, you know, in general, I kind of feel like it would be best to follow.
Don't interrupt you, but when they were like, what needs to happen if this could be, ultimately this can be as simple or as complex as you make it. I'm like,
right.
This is your guidance.
I'm simple.
Yeah. I second that.
Yes, I'm not interested in making this a really complicated.
Because I don't think they know what the process
is. Yeah. Well, and again, you know, as we talked about, it's so frustrating not to have some kind of clear what's going to happen with these
reports.
What is the outcome of this? You know what I mean? It just seems like this is not the best use of taxpayer funds to have myself or an administrative staff to spend time doing this.
Well, we clear is that nobody will be compensated extra.
Right.
That's your
right.
Which makes me wonder, will they have funds to put in place any efficiencies that
right.
we recommend?
Right.
And who's coming up with the monies for that?
Yeah.
Are we literally holding one of these meetings right now?
No, we are not. So they actually have to, you can hold them on the same evenings that the board meetings are, but you would have to adjourn this meeting and officially open, and it has to have a separate agenda, a separate open meetings. It has to comply with all the open meetings that guidelines and rules. So anyway, like I said, I just included this because it gave just a little bit more information about potentially what's
Yeah, I mean, it's still just, I mean, let's spend some time and talk about policies to increase efficiency, it just seems, you know, counterintuitive. But we will do our due diligence, so. So yes, I will, you know, keep everyone posted, hopefully by next month, you know, who our committee members are. If we need to, you know, so those are posted for this week, if we can, but we can figure that out, so. Okay, to be continued. New business, so. This is, it's a cover letter from Frank, from our attorney. So, we're going to open this up. Let's do a motion, so I'll make a motion to approve the ethics policy.
Second. Very thorough.
Is this the first one we've ever met?
Yes. It's the first actual ethics policy we have. We do have a section in our employee handbook that covers, there's a very brief blurb about ethics, and there's another brief blurb about accepting gifts, but there was never any dollar amounts assigned or anything, and I don't know off the top of my head what's in the board bylaws, but this, as if you read it over, it would cover both the board and staff. But it's sort of the first policy that we have that is as involved as this.
So does this have to be reviewed every year, like the policies or anything?
No. The only time it would potentially have to be reviewed is if, so this policy is taken very much from a sample model ordinance like policy from the Illinois Attorney General.
Mm-hmm.
And so it covers a lot of different things, some of which apply to us, some of which don't. But so the only time that we would potentially think about changing this is if for some reason the guidance from the Illinois Attorney General changed. Or, you know, if they changed the dollar amounts for what public employees and board members can accept. Because right now it's whatever, it's like $121 and $75 in another. So if some of those actual dollar amounts change.
Okay. I mean, so the policy committee is not something that's going to this.
Yeah.
I mean, the policy in this way.
Right. So it's not, this will be, as I mentioned tonight in the draft report, is that if the board approves it this evening, we will incorporate it into our employee handbook, which is not something that the policies that the policy committee and the board approves, those things are just incorporated. So, and then also, and then we would probably suggest that the board incorporate it when you look at the bylaws for the year.
Okay. Yeah, okay. Does anybody have any questions? Any other questions? I have not. That's what you said. Okay, so we'll start with Joe.
Yes. Lisa Jen?
Yes.
Volunteers? Puzo?
Yes.
Flores?
Yes.
Gonzalez?
Yes.
Okay, so communications, everyone did receive a fact sheet about filing a statement of economic interests.
Peaceful, but it's dead time of year again, so I know that's certainly more onerous. That it has been in subsequent or previous years, so.
And nobody's received it.
I know that, right?
I know that we were like, did you get it? Because I didn't get it.
I was looking for a date.
It's mid-March, because I saved it. We'll just try to track what to expect the next one, so we still have time.
But I have to focus out and the images as well, so it's not just.
Okay, I'm always waiting for it.
Yeah, I just thought this was helpful because it's
it really makes you feel like you're doing everything wrong, you know, like second guessing.
Yeah, right.
You're just like, I don't know.
Can I talk to you outside?
Yeah.
Absolutely not.
Yeah, it's, you know, I mean, it's unfortunately, you know, they have to create these kinds of procedures and policies because there are people that have to work in the and be able to use their positions as stewards of the public tax money. You don't do that here, obviously, but. It can feel punitive when we're already following all the rules.
But it is helpful to that, so thank you for doing that. We also were given a copy of, a graphic of the stats, kind of so highly cares for us, as well as some information about a trustee banquet on May.
Yeah, so I did email the trustees about this. I heard back from one trustee that's been attending, but I thought I'd give you the piece of paper. Sometimes I know it's easier to refer back to that. They, with COVID, I used to do this every year. They would have a trustee dinner. And with COVID, it's half years I haven't, so this is the first year I've been in person since COVID. So if you are interested in attending, Lyle and Freddie, anything that she wants to attend, I will attend that. But if that's something you want to do, let me know, and I'll.
Joy and I are supposed to eighth grade dance that night, so.
Okay.
It's amazing, so.
Then I'll be excited.
Right.
It should be pretty interesting. I go,
Yeah.
The two speakers that I have, one of them is the three, because there's always an interview, you know, talking about things that apply to my work. Joe Philippi, the trustee that's going to talk, he's actually also an employee of Rails. But he's a trustee from New York Public Library and was actually the Illinois Library trustee of the year this past year. And he's really personal and I'm really going to work with him in the class. So I think it should be a good program. Besides, you get trustee, you can't, but I don't know. Like, so let me know and then we'll get into it.
Good chance to network. Okay. I think that's it. We have, shorter agenda today. So, public comments, non-agenda items, still just us. So we'll talk about that, everybody. It is 7:24.